I'd like to welcome everybody who's seen me before on these things and all the newcomers that are checking this out. It's really cool. I really enjoy doing this. And I'd like to start off thanking Joe Fuoco, who is the owner of GoDPS.com, which is the mother company of Chromacast, who makes the hardware, and Sawtooth drums, which are these drums here. And I'll tell you about the equipment in a little bit. What I wanted to get into, first I'm going to start, I'll play a song. And then after that, I'm going to show you some of the interesting drum intros and beats and feels. A lot of them that I used that I'll play them for you. And then a couple of Zep ones that are great, of course. And explain to you how you can practice that and get the feel of some of these things. Because Bonzo, as you know, is quite tricky. And hopefully my brother Carmine is watching. Hi, Carmine. I keep sending him the link. He never gets it. He goes, send me the link. I said, I sent you four links. So hopefully he can check it out. And he's getting set up to record at his house in Florida, too. So anyway, so I'm going to start off with a song from the Last in Line album. And this is the Last in Line 2 album. And it doesn't have drums in it. It's a little tricky to play. There's a lot of little holes in the song. This one's called False Flag, featuring Andrew Freeman on vocals, killing it. Vivian Campbell on guitar, you guys know him. And Phil Soussan on bass. And so I'm going to play that for you and check it out. And then I'll come back and we'll do a little gabbing, okay? Here we go.
Another soul for sale. About the days to die.
Okay, that was False Flag. Thank you. You guys couldn't hear the music. Sorry about that. And at the end, I let it end because there's an odd count there. I don't even know what it is. A lot of the stuff we recorded in the studio, and everybody watched me when we ended, you know. So there's no real count. It's kind of avant-garde, so... That's False Flag and Kill a Solo by Viv, and Andy singing his rear end off. And that's off Last in Line 2. We're working on 3. We got half of it done. It's a little harder to get it done these days with everything, you know, closed down and slowed down and all that stuff. So anyway, last week what I did was I played the song and then I played it crazy, you know, and by that... It's like a good way to practice because a lot of people practice with CDs and they play to the music, but they play exactly to the music, which is cool. But you want to maybe try some licks, play all over the place, go a little more crazy. This way you can practice the licks that you learned or you feel something else, and nobody's going to yell at you because there's no band, you know, so... It's a good way to practice. I'll play a little of it. This song's a little bit harder to do stuff in because it's fast and it's... I'll play a couple, little bit of it. I'm just going to play off the cuff, okay? So if I learned, you know, a new lick like... things like that or... any of these licks. If you learn licks, they don't have to be this complicated. They can be... And you just try it in the song because the song becomes a metronome. And you got to play to the song. And, you know, if you go off, which I probably will, you go, whoa, get back on. And you learn something, you know, that way. I'll play a little bit like that, okay? Here we go. Got to click too.
Yeah.
Okay, so as you can see, I just played a lot of stuff in a lot of places, and nobody yelled at me. They don't yell at me anyway. I'm Italian. I've been doing this too many years. But that's just overkill, you know, but it's a good way to practice. And a lot of stuff I do some of this stuff on the recordings. It's what I feel, you know, what I feel in that song. Each song kind of paints a picture. It's like an artist for me. And I got to get the right vibe. And I do a lot of recording in this room. And sometimes just playing the right feel simply, like just a simple beat. Just a verse might have that kind of feel to it, but to lock it in sometimes could take a half an hour, believe it or not. Because I try to make sure it's like right in the song. So I don't want to just put anything in these songs. The other problem is if I'm playing with a band that I'm not used to playing with, nobody's in the room, but I'm playing to their track and they have a different feel. As opposed to my band, Viv and I have played together for over 30 years, even though there was a big gap in between, but we still have the same feel. It's amazing. And Phil and I played in different things. And as a rhythm section, we lock in. So it's a lot easier. And Andrew's, you know, we're all on the same page. So, all right. So now what we're going to do is get this other stuff up here. Okay. I got very, very serious notes on this. Let's see. Ripped off. Half a page. I cut that with the scissor because I knew I wouldn't remember this. Okay, on the Black Sabbath album, 1992, it was called The Humanizer, right? And I did an intro for the song, and it starts with the drums. And when we went to record it, we recorded the whole song, and then we said, all right, we want a drum intro. So then I go back in the room, and they go, okay, just play something, you know. So I start playing something, and then we record it. We go, next, play something else, about 10 or 12 different things. And we settle on this drum intro, which is just a beat. I'm going to play it for you. This actually has some sound effects in the beginning, and then the beat comes in, and I'll explain the beat a little bit more. So let's see if this works. Here we go. The Humanizer. This is called Computer God. I guess it's supposed to be computer noises. Can't hear it. So that's Computer God. So the trick to that one is instead of coming up with just a beat, very 2 and 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. You know, anybody can do that or think of that. So what I did was I just kept playing, but somehow I came up with something that's a little bit more syncopated and off, like this. See? So it's kind of part of a normal, the beginning part is a kind of a normal, you know. Then here we go back to the bass drum, more of a bass drum sound. Like hole. Okay, so it gets syncopated and changes it up, and it feels real good. It doesn't lose the groove. So, drum key. A lot of the beats with the bass drum, you know, some cool stuff. A lot of this stuff came from some of the Motown stuff, you know. My brother, a long time ago, showed me a beat by Howlin' Wolf. And I was like, really weird. It was this. You know, to me, as a young kid, it was like, wow, that's really weird, because he's going, there's no, you know, 2 and 4. You're putting the bass drum in the place of the snare drum for a second and getting this other kind of feel to it, you know? And that was from, the artist was Howlin' Wolf, and there was some really cool stuff. I always remember that beat because it was so odd to not play the snare, you know? So, all right, so that's that one. And then this one, you probably heard a little bit of it. I get asked this all the time, what's the intro to Straight Through the Heart? So let me play it here on the recording. Yeah. Here it goes. I faded these out a little too quick, I think. So that intro is actually just triplets. One and a two and a one and a two and a one and a two. The triplets, but then they become replacement triplets. It's the same triplet, but I'm playing replacements like this. See? See, one and a two in it. So if you want to break it down where it's just parts, it's one of those. And then there's three of those. So you got one, two, three. And the last part is one and a two and a one. See? So you got and that last part is two on the bass drum. So you got to play it nice and steady. You don't want to play it like this. That's not good. So. So then what we did in the studio is I just played that across the toms. Slow. Hard to play slow. A lot of things are hard to play slow. And the reason why this gets asked a lot, because we recorded one take with me playing that riff. I had one more tom here, so it was more of a spread of the drums. Going from high to low, and then we overdubbed me going from low to high. And if you listen to the record, it starts like this, each take, and then they cross over and they're panned until they get to the other side. So it's got this weird effect. You know, that was my idea. I said, hey, Ronnie, let's do this. And it worked really good, and I get asked about that song all the time. Okay. That's Straight Through the Heart. This is a Sabbath song called TV Crimes, and this is just a way of playing a fast song, and then there was a certain riff. I just felt this riff, and Geezer Butler and I just locked in. Okay, so check this out. Here we go.
Nice fade.
Okay, a couple things in that song. Very fast song. The beginning is... because I don't play double bass, you know, double bass would have been probably... I don't have double bass, so this was more punkish almost. This was recorded in 92, don't forget. So bass drums on the ends, you know, so it fills up nicely. And we don't get lost because everybody, you know, Tony Iommi is so steady when he plays that I was able to play in that, you know, down. And it worked. And then the fast part, it's like I didn't want to play just... same thing on the hi-hat, so I went there. The second part is... like that kind of thing, like a fast shuffle, little country and western there. And that worked well, and it eliminates, you know, when you can create parts rather than anybody can play. We do that a lot, but, you know, whenever you can think of other parts, and that's what Ringo did good, believe it or not. You know, he's not a technical drummer. Some of the parts were so creative that was more important than technical, you know. Not when I was younger, and when I was younger, I just wanted to rock. But now I listen and go, that's very creative. So I'm an adult now, some part, a little bit. So that's the kind of shuffle. And the next part, I just played, Tony was hitting the chords, and I went. See, so that is like, it's almost like a riff, you know? And if you listen to the song, Geezer's locked right in with me. Boom, down, boom, doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. And he's able to play his runs in between. So that's a cool part. And when you can play some riffs on the drums. See, it's a cool thing. So one other thing I wanted to point out, that's the next part. When it goes boom, that's a Sabbath-y way of playing a hit. I didn't play, you know, I didn't play. The hit is. Bop, 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 bop. I could have played, you know, but a lot of stuff with Sabbath, I went up on the cymbals and just, it made it more dark and more mysterious. Like. If you listen to some of the stuff I played on with them, you'll hear that, and it's a lot darker. Okay, and then everybody keeps asking me about this song, Don't Tell the Kids, which was on I don't know what album that was, with Dio. It's a long time ago, 90-something, 6 or 7. I don't know, because can you play the intro? The intro was kind of avant-garde. I'll play a little bit for you. Listen to this. This is crazy. Must have had a lot of coffee that day, because that is really fast. And I haven't listened to that album, but somebody kept asking about that song and the intro. I said, let me listen to this album. And it was blew me away. I said this on one of the other lessons too. And it's just like more of a prog rock album with Ronnie singing. It's amazing. So it's a really good album. Check it out if you got time. And that intro, now I can say I played it, but I didn't play it, is just, you know, just a whole bunch of licks. And I think we probably put it together, cheating, where the guitar hit those chords. Da, 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 because there's no way I would be playing like that and be able to know we're doing this thing together with the guitar. So I think, you know, with the recording, you can just go, ba, ba, boom, okay, you got that? And then put all the crazy stuff, mix it in, splice in that part, you know, paste it in, and it sounds like you really knew what you were doing. So anyway, that's that one. Let's do this one, The Crunch, right? Let's play that by Led Zeppelin. Here we go.
It's all about experience.
After this.
Control. You might as well be one.
Nice slow fade. Okay, here comes The Crunch. Cool thing about that thing, that beat is everything. That's in 9/8, right? So trick to doing that is so first you gotta cop the feel. It's 9/8. So slow. Okay, so the two hi-hats in there, the first one's open, second one is open, but with two bass drums, which is really weird. First one, second one, so slow again. Oops, how'd that get in there? See? So that's the trick to that beat. So a good way to play is just play. And there's that. It's kind of like a grace note. If you can't get that double bass in there, practice like that. See? And the last hi-hat, the double, you open it, you got to feel where you should close it. See? Closes just in time before the rest of the beat comes in. So that's that one. And then there's this one. Okay, that one is, I wrote a book a long time ago called Rock Steady, and I had these fours and sixes in it, and it's actually similar to one of the things I had in the book a long time ago. Say one, two, three, four, ah. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, one and a, two and a, one and a, two and a, one and a. That's the basic, part of that beat. See? So But I'm playing the bass drum with the right. I'm playing the bass drum with the right hand. So, and then the grace note again. I play with the grace note. Bonham seems to do one. I don't play it his way, but I hear one in there. So. So that's the six. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. That's the basic thing. So bass drum with the right hand in the beginning. Then you open the hi-hat. Like that. See, so that's that beat. The last part there was a double paradiddle. Right, left, right, left, right, right, left, right, left, right, left, left. Right hand with the bass drum. So. Bunch of them together. You don't want to do that. Good practice, but you know. Okay. While we're on the subject of Led Zeppelin, I promise you I'd show you this. A piece of rock memorabilia. This is Bonzo's drumstick. Try to get close. Can you see it? It's like any other drumstick, except he used it. And it says John Bonham on it. So, and I verified that this is actually the stick. So, that's a little prized possession of mine. Quickly, these drums, I want to just tell you real quick what these are. These are Command Series, they're called. And they're not expensive drums. They're very value kind of series of drums for the money. And this is poplar wood. And they got a lot of tone to them, a lot of ring and warmth. You know, and bass drum. Great drums, and I like drums that have a lot of tone and that I can hear, and they're loud. These guys are loud. Snare drum, this is a hickory snare. This is a 6.5 hickory drum, and this is coming out soon, and it's a little more higher-end drum, and I'm getting the whole set like this, you know. Great sounding snare drum. And this snare drum is one of these snare drums where I bring it to the studio or I bring it here. I put it up on the mic and it sounds great. Very little tuning. The stands are Chromacast. Cool thing with these stands, they have one lever. I don't know if you can see it in the front of this stand. And that adjusts this way and it adjusts that way. So you don't have to undo two things. And I've done this on stage if I wanted to change the angle. There's enough time to do it with one lever where there's a little bit of a hang in a song. Stand up, boom! And I've already adjusted it. That's so quick. Very strong. Drums are strong. And the cymbals are double A Sabians. Great cymbals. Very loud, but great. And they work perfect for me. Heads are all Evans G2s on everything except the snare. That's the level 360. So this is the stuff I use. These sticks are 5Bs. And these are Chromacast sticks also. So check it out. Check their website out. They got everything. Guitars, basses, a whole bunch of stuff. And we're going to do a couple of special events coming up. maybe next month with maybe a couple of the artists that are on Chromacast and Go DPS, and we'll bring that to you too, and it's going to be good. So anyway, I want to thank everybody for watching, and I hope you learned something and the hour took you away from wherever you wanted to be taken away from. And we'll be doing this every Tuesday at 4 p.m. And I want to thank Chromacast and Joe Fuco, Sawtooth Drums, for putting this together. And next week I'll think of some other crazy stuff to do, and hopefully it works. I thought we'd take apart some beats here and show you what how they work and how to do them, approach them, you know. So good luck, everybody. Stay safe, and thanks for tuning in. Bye-bye.